Hello everyone and welcome back to Vernon Gaming. You currently join me on Dirt Rally, where we're going to be doing episode 10 of our career mode. As you can see in the top right hand corner, we've currently got about 50,000 credits, 48,000 to be precise. I have been doing some driving on this game off camera to try and build up our credits that little bit extra. So if we get a good result in this episode, yeah, that makes sense. We can actually think about buying a new car. Now, I've had a little think about what car to go for. I'm not going to give away too much. Wait, blah, blah, blah. I want to resume. Okay, sorry. I've had a little think. Don't want to give away too much, but it will be... Actually, no, I'm not going to say that. Put in the comment section, guys, what car you might think I will get. It's in the next tier up. I will show you the next tier at the end of the video with all the cars in it and everything. So you put down in the comment section what car you reckon I'll get. It'll be quite interesting to see the variety of, well, like the cars that people think I might get. So anyway, getting straight into the first race, cars rolling up now, waiting for the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 to come on. Where is it? We just sat here. Come on. What is this game doing? Oh, there we go. Right, yeah. So 3, 2, 1, and we're off for the, I didn't really see where we were. We're going to turn the lights on straight away. There we go. And oh my gosh, the understeer in this car is real. Come on, get back up on the track. Going in reverse, come on. Stupid car. There we go. Not very good first corner. Last episode was actually, believe it or not, quite successful. We don't normally have successful videos on Vernon Gaming, but apparently last video was a good video. We've got lots of credits, and hopefully if we get a good result like we did last video on this video, we will be able to buy the new car, like I said. So, the first bit of this course hasn't been too great for us. I do love the Germany course. Not as much as Monaco, I don't think. I think Monte Carlo is my favourite one. Germany is my second favourite. And, I don't know, I don't like this one at all. It's just, it's really hard to drive around and everything like that. And... oh my dear, I was braking and turning, my car just wouldn't turn in. It's so bad, I absolutely hate this track. So yeah, as you can see, crashing into everything that is there. That's all good. Lovely lad, jobbler. So we're already about 50 seconds down, and knowing me, we're just going to lose more and more time. I'm just mounting every single dirt bit there is. Oh my days, I'm absolutely so annoying. Already a minute and 2 seconds down after the first sector. If we carry on like this, we're going to finish like at the bottom, 5 minutes down. Oh my days, it's going to be horrible. So we need to start thinking about trying to pick up the pace and like start thinking ahead about each corner and everything. That was shocking, literally. Like last episode, the car felt so responsive. Every time I turned the wheel in, it turned straight in afterwards. But now it just feels so... it's probably because we're on gravel, the tyres are digging in and stuff. But it's like, it's so loose, the steering. You turn in and it's just not doing anything. It's like understeer central. I'm really struggling to try and keep the car on the track. But hopefully we can make the best out of a bad situation and leave this episode with a good amount of credits. So the second sector, I don't know how bad we're going to be. Well, we've gained a bit of time. I say a bit of time, we've lost it all now. And we've just rolled the Mini. That's great, isn't it? So trying to get it back on two wheels and get back in the direction we're going. About 1 minute 15 seconds down now. Oh dear, that's a tree. Literally, guys, I'm not liking this track at all. As you could probably tell in the tone of my voice, I'm so annoyed because compared to last video, I thought we were getting somewhere on this channel with my driving. Obviously not, because I'm still as shocking as I am as I was before. I mean, not as bad as the first episode, where I literally just drove straight off the cliff. But, you know, never mind. We need to try and keep going in this car. Hopefully, we don't crash off and make it unrecoverable. We were doing absolutely shocking in the first sector, but now we're picking up some speed. Hopefully, we don't crash off. I bet you now I said that we are going to... Really? Literally, as soon as I say anything about not doing something, we have to do it, don't we? But that crash may have acted as a corner cut slightly, so I'm not going to complain, because we managed to keep the car on the track, and we didn't... Well, no, off, we didn't keep the car on the track, but we didn't lose too much time now. I think we go straight on here. Yes, I was actually thinking that it was a hairpin, but it really wasn't, because that's where all the cars are parked up down there. The Mini's a little bit damaged. Now, where are we going? Not straight on again. I get so confused at those bits. They need to put arrows there saying that it's straight on. But we're about a minute and 43 seconds down. That's absolutely terrible, guys. I honestly don't know what's happened to my driving. It's either the driving or my mood, because some people say that you can actually tell what mood people are in by the way that they're driving. I don't know if that's true or not. But if it is, I'm getting frustrated now, and that means my driving's going to get worse, apparently. Oh, my days. Like that, and we're going to roll the car and have to take the penalty to try and get back onto the track as quickly as possible. Rocks there and everything. So, oh, dear, guys. Not a very good first race on this Dirt Rally Episode 10. But, you know, hopefully we can get rid of the Lancia and the Mini by the end of this video and try and, well, not by the end of this video, by the start of next video, and get a new car. We're about to go 2 minutes down. There we go, guys. We're about two minutes and like 3 seconds, that 4 or 5 seconds down. Oh my days, guys, just terrible. The finish line's right there. I'm trying to get back on the track. It's just not working now. I won't be able to get back on the track if we hang on like this. Just need to recover the vehicle. Oh, guys, our radiator's damaged, it's all smashed up, the radiator light's on. Not particularly good first race, all the way in 7th place, guys. If we carry on like this, we're not going to get a decent amount of money to get a new car. Oh dear, I really not liking this circuit. I wouldn't be surprised if we managed to find a way to crash off and make it an unrecoverable car. Oh my days, guys. I'm probably going to have to really concentrate in the next video. Not next video, next race. So I'm going to just fast forward it pretty much all of it. And then, yeah, I'll join you at the end of the race. So I'll just cut ahead onto the... Oh, wait, no, I won't, because it's already here. So, yeah, here we go, guys. I'm just going to start fast forwarding about now and then, like, you know, I'll speak to you at the end. See you then. Starting to come towards the end of this lap now. This lap, not a lap, this race has been absolutely atrocious. Literally every single time I could find a way to take the car off the track, I just made sure I just drove across there, make sure everything's in working order, you know, in all the ditches and everything. And all the ditches look fine from my view. We're not actually that far down off the pace, but we will be if we do stuff like that. And across the line, there we go. That was a... Oh dear, we're a bit at an angle. I can't believe we didn't crash then, but that sneaky little corner cut, got us fifth place. The guy in front of us had ECU problem and we still didn't manage to beat him. That's a bit embarrassing. But we've gone up two places in the championship leading standing thingy bob. So we're now in fifth place. That'll get us a lot better amount of credits. The reason we've gone up two places is because H. Usunlen 10, whatever his name is, has gone down six places, and T. Otterson has gone down nine places. And for those two people, I swear they're really high up in the overall championships from in this season. So I think that is going to really hurt them massively. So yeah, the fact they're so far down now, that's quite shocking. So yeah, that was a lot quicker than the previous one, as you can see, 15 minutes and blah, 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 seconds. And not 15 minutes, 5 minutes and 15 seconds. And compared to our 6 minutes and 23 seconds on the first one. So yeah, that's all good. The next one we've got is in Ompelenos Origami, apparently. So yeah, go to go there now. I swear every single time I do this, and I just assume it's just going to be radiator. Yeah, there we go. Oh wait, no, there is one down here, suspension. They want us to repair that as well. So what we're going to do is going to get straight into it. Our radiator, we fixed the radiator as much as we could, but the radiator light is still on. So I'm not surprised if, well, we're going to have to nurse this radiator home, hopefully, and try not crash into as many things as possible, which for me is very difficult because you know what I'm like, guys. I just love to try and crash into things. Oh dear, that was a very tight corner. This Mini is really struggling on this gravel. Like every single corner, it's just struggling to get the it's just struggling to even go around the corner and stop going straight on. Like here, literally, like I'm full lot left and it's still going straight on. Like if that's not understeer, I don't know what actually is. But yeah, we're not doing too bad. If we can, I'm going to try and go as quickly as possible, but isn't that like kind of what you aim to do? I'm not going to say that we're up 11 seconds because that means that we're going to crash off, but I just said it and now we're like down. No, yeah, oh my god, really, guys. I said, oh, and now we're down 12 seconds. I literally said, if we say, yeah, I'm going to crash off, and what did we do? We crashed off. And come on, turn, you stupid Mini. Stop trying to go over the flipping mountain. Oh my days. Seriously, guys, this car. We've had some banter on it, but now it's just getting annoying because I just want to progress and it's just not even a good car. Like, oh my days. And, guys, in case you have realised, some of you might have not, but the cars that I've been selling on Forza Horizon 3, basically, I kind of lost my disc. So I couldn't put them on the auction site as well on the times that I put on the video. That's annoying because I thought I could get a corner cut in there. So yeah, basically what I'm going to try and do is I'm just going to put them on the auction site whenever, and then I'm going to put a message on Instagram telling you when I've done it. I'm going to put them on the auction sites a little bit longer then, so you guys can put it up, or can put your bids in and stuff like that for the cars. I'm just beast on those rocks, so we might as well just recover the vehicle and get going again. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do about the Vernon Gaming cars on Forza Horizon 3. So like I said, just whenever they've been put on the auction site, just put a quick message on Instagram. Yeah, and then I will... well, then obviously you know that a Vernon Gaming car has been put on sale. So yeah, we're about a minute down off the pace after the second sector. Hopefully we can gain a bit of that, because I don't think that is a position where we want. Well, I don't think that would be good enough for fourth or fifth, which is the minimum that we want to be down the grid. So if we're below 4th or 5th, I'm not happy. There we go. Because I don't know whether it's minimum or maximum. CFC Samson is online. That's Matthew Samson. Shout out to him. He's a Forza Sweat and an absolute unit. I don't even know why I said that, an absolute unit. It's because he says everyone's a unit and as a diss, and he doesn't even know what it means. So yeah, shout out to him. He's not the smartest person in the world, but you know, we'll let him go with that. But okay, carrying on, coming towards the end of the third sector, about a minute and 18 seconds down, which is even worse than what it was last time. So I really don't think we'll be able to. No, 1 minute and 24. Wow, we are not on the pace at all. I don't know whether it's because we damaged our car and it's now going slower or what, but well, I don't even know. So coming towards the end, coming towards the middle of the fourth sector, we've overshot that corner, an absolute beast, and I don't even know why the game reset us there. That is so annoying. I could have got away with that, just killed a few people by running them over, and then we would have got away with it. But obviously the game does not want us to kill a few people, and it reset us, so that's depressing. The fact that the game reset us, not the fact I couldn't kill anyone. Okay, I should shut up, because I'm just digging myself into a deeper hole. This race, it's been going on for ages. Like, this is a problem about these tracks with all the gravel and everything. Like, it just slows the Mini right down completely, and then it lasts forever. So I'm probably going to have to fast forward the next race just a little bit to try and keep the video under like 20 minutes or just over. Oh my days, that rock just spun us around completely and we're off the track again. Come on, we need to get over the line. Oh, below 2 minutes, come on guys. 3, 2, oh, only just below 2 minutes. There's our absolutely wrecked Mini, and I don't think we would be able to get fifth place. No, seventh place is for us. And where are we in the table? Oh, we're just in fifth place by 10 seconds. We have to do a decent run on the next race to try and keep that fifth place position. Yes, right. Yeah, that makes sense, I think. How long's this video been going for? About 20 minutes, and I did fast forward that other race. So it'll probably be about, I don't know, 17 minutes now. I don't know. I'm probably going to have to fast forward the last bit of the race on this race. I'll probably stay with you for the start, and then the middle two sectors I'll fast forward, and then the last sector I'll be with you again. Yeah, that makes sense. So right, coming on to the final race, hopefully this one will go a lot better than the previous two. Yeah, so we've got a turn six corner coming up according to the co-driver. Apparently we've just gone around that, and now five. I think the lower the number, the sharper the corner. So that's what the numbers mean. So if there's like a 1, that means really sharp. So now there's a 3 and a 6. It's actually quite a smooth track, to be honest. I think the track's going to start getting wider now. But it's quite a smooth track at the moment. There's not been very many sharp corners, but there's a 1 coming up. So yeah, that's a sharp corner-ish there. But yeah, it's quite flowing, this track. It's not hairpin after hairpin like the other ones. A few 90 degree corners like this one here. But if the track stays like this, I think it'll be able to suit the Mini's driving style and my driving style, obviously, because I just like to keep my foot heavily on the accelerator and then just try and drive around everywhere. But the Mini is understeering quite a lot already, and I'm having to the wheels aren't aligned to my wheel, so it means we've obviously hit something, because I have to steer slightly left to try and go in a straight line. So we've obviously hit something that's damaged our car, but we're about 15 seconds up, so obviously this track is suiting the Mini's driving style. But I'm going to fast forward now to try and concentrate on the race and everything like that, and to try and keep this positive delta or negative or whatever it is. Okay, so see you in a minute. Thank you. guys literally just, I thought we crashed a car and made it unrecoverable then. But no, we crashed it, but we had to recover it. Oh, no. This is where the car would be deemed unrecoverable if we went off here. And we've just got about 30 seconds worth of penalties in the like first 100 metres of the final sector, which means we're going to be in a really bad position for the table constructors championship, not constructors, just championship thingy bobby thing. Yeah, as you can see on the left hand side of the screen, so far we've only done one sector that's been slower than the leader. The other two have been quicker because we've only done one slower. Anyway, well, that's quite obvious, isn't it? But never mind. So yeah, I think our good pace isn't going to be, well, it's like gone out the window now as we've had those 30 seconds worth of penalties. So yeah, not the greatest. I thought we were doing really well, and I was about to start saying, oh, you know what, guys, we've done really well, and I'm planning, I'm saying all that, and then obviously we drove off. But we're coming towards the end of the final section now. Yeah, we are about 30 seconds down, which is really annoying, because if without those two penalties, we will be about only 6 seconds down. So flying towards the finish line now. Our Mini looks quite wrecked at the moment, so... Oh my days, guys, where did we finish? We still managed to finish third, even though we were 41 seconds off the pace, which is good. So where do we finish overall? We finished fourth. That's even better than last... Well, not even better than last time. But we've got about 30,000 credits. So I wonder how much money we got now. We've moved up to fourth in the overall championship standings. That's the open one. So having a look, see how much money we got now. I don't want to look at this. I want to go to the main menu, so we're probably just going to start the race then go to the main menu to see how much money we have. So once it's finished loading, I'm just going to press X, and I think that will take us back. So I honestly don't know how much money some of these cars, well, no, I obviously do, but I don't know how much money we've got altogether. I think we have about 50,000 before, and now we've got about 29,000, so about 79,000 roughly. I think that's enough to even get the best car here. Oh no, you can't press X here. You're just going to have to... Oh, yeah, there we can. Yep, save and quit. So we're going to go back to the main menu, have a look at some of the cars that we could buy, and, well, we'll have a look to see, yeah, all that good stuff. So if you go into the garage, look here. So these are the cars that that we are going to hopefully try and buy. So write which car you want to see, or no, write which car you think I'm going to buy in the next episode. We've got the Opel, the Fiat, the Ford, or the Lancia. Obviously the Lancia is the quickest, I think. It's got the slightly better stats, but it does have a slightly higher price. And when I say slightly higher, I mean about 10,000 credits more than pretty much all of these ones. So if we do go for the Lancia, it's going to be quite a big risk, because if it doesn't work for us, we start right from the bottom again. So write in the comment section which one you think we should go for, the Opel, the Fiat, the Ford, or the Lancia. I've been Vernon Gaming, and until the next video, guys, goodbye.